Welcome to Ushendra's Engineering Tutorials. It's something about constructing a shunt type ohmmeter. A basic meter with empty scale will be given. We have to obtain the scale of unknown resistances. So we have a empty here. We have empty basic meter. It's a basic meter construction. Everything is fine, but no scale on that. We have to obtain the scale in terms of unknown resistances. Right? Basic meter we have. And here we go, the construction. We have a supply battery, a DC battery E, DC battery E, and here we have a current limiting resistor R1 to limit the current through the basic meter, so that it doesn't exceed full scale deflection current, and it would be incomplete. We cannot move ahead with the discussions if we forget this, if we neglect this RM. What is that RM? The internal resistance of the basic meter, right? And not something else. Switch is provided over here. Switch connection, switch S is provided over here. So what are the use of that? When the ohmmeter, when the instrument isn't in working, it's switched off, so that we can save the life of the battery, so that it doesn't get drained. And on the other hand, here we have that terminal. Let's give some name for this one. It's a A and B. Now the deflection of the pointer of the basic meter will be due to the flow of current only, that's okay, but the position of the pointer will be indicating the resistance across A and B. In this case, what is A and B? It's open, completely open. AB is found to be open, and we have to make sure that the switch S is closed in this point. At this point, the switch S is closed. It's closed, and the circuit is complete. And R1 should be selected in such a way that in this current will be flowing through this loop, and we have to make sure that IFSD is flowing. Right, the value of R1 is selected in such a way that this allows the resistance, amount of resistance allows the passage of IFSD in the loop. So when IFSD is flowing, where the pointer position would be, I guess it's the pointer takes the maximum deflection like this. Okay, the deflection is due to the flow of current, but what should that indicate? That should indicate the resistance across A and B. Now A and B is open. What will be the resistance across an open circuit? It's infinite, right? So we have this infinite. The resistance across A and B. On the other hand, short circuiting this AB. No more current through the basic meter. Why? Because all the current will be bypassed. Short circuit, zero resistance, almost zero, in the sense this resistance will be very much lower than, so the entire current is bypassed through this side, so no current through the basic meter, so the pointer, it's no more, the pointer position will be over here, no deflection, pointer over here. And what is that position? That position which indicates the resistance across AB. AB is shorted, short circuit, 0 ohms. So this is how we obtain. So how to get the intermediate markings? By placing known values of resistance across A and B. 1K, placing 1K, for supposing 1K is placed over here. Pointer may be somewhere here. So that mark 1K. Place a 2K, known values of resistance. It will be somewhere else here. That does 2K. Guys, check the scale, it's 0 to infinity. In the series type ohmmeter, it's in reverse. It's 0 and infinity. Please check that. In the shunt type ohmmeter, we have a 0 to infinity in order. So where do we find the application? While measuring low value resistances, right? Please make a note.